Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 11, where we're going to focus on the muscles of mastication, of which there are four. So let's start with the two largest of the muscles of mastication and also the most superficial. And these are the temporalis, which you can see here and here. And the temporalis is going to be this large fan-shaped muscle that is going to be more superiorly placed, with its distal attachment or its inferior attachment on that coronoid process, which you can see really nicely right here because the masseter has been reflected. So you can see that temporalis really taking up a lot of the temple region and coming to insert on the mandible, like all of the muscles of mastication will have to do because they are moving the mandible during mastication or chewing. Now here you can really see the ramus of the mandible, or that vertical portion of the mandible with the masseter reflected. Here on this particular image, the masseter has not been reflected, and you can really see that it completely occludes the view of the ramus of the mandible because it's covering that area. So a very large, very coarsely fibered muscle. Both of these muscles, if you kind of put your hand where, like if you put your hand on your temple region and clench your jaw, you can feel the temporalis contracting. And the same thing, if you put your hand on the ramus of the mandible, you can feel your masseter muscle contracting. Now, when talking about the other two muscles of mastication, the pterygoid muscles, you really have to get into a deeper dissection in order to be able to see these. So you have to reflect or remove those superficial mastication muscles. So here you can see the temporalis muscle has been reflected, the masseter muscle has been reflected, and then in fact we've actually had to remove portions of the ramus of the mandible in order to better see these muscles. The lateral pterygoid muscle is going to be the more superior of the two, and it's going to have two bellies. We have the superior belly of the lateral pterygoid and the inferior belly of the lateral pterygoid. And you can see that both have a really close relationship to the actual TMJ joint. It's really that superior that's going to have a direct articulation there. And you also have a fairly large artery kind of running right over this region called the maxillary artery that will serve the deep face region. The medial pterygoid muscle is going to be right here. And this almost directly mirrors the masseter muscle, but on the deep side of the ramus of the mandible. So if we kind of flopped back the masseter muscle into its place, it would be in a fairly similar relationship just on the other side of the ramus of the mandible. So if you have something that's really closely related to the ramus, but on the deep side, you know you're looking at the medial pterygoid. Okay, so those are the four muscles of mastication. Thank you for your time and attention here, and as always, please reach out if you have any questions.